Good morning class, good morning everyone. In this video, I'm going to share with you how to create your activity 1 in Microsoft PowerPoint. First, to open Microsoft PowerPoint, you can simply double click the shortcut icon on the desktop. This PowerPoint, you can double click. Another way, type at the search box PowerPoint. Okay, then you can see the shortcut for the application. So to open, just simply click once, then you wait till Microsoft PowerPoint environment appears. Okay, so these are the templates in Microsoft PowerPoint. So to begin creating your activity 1, you just simply click blank presentation. Okay, so to customize, to create your placeholders for text and graphics or images, you can actually erase these placeholders that is the default when you open Microsoft PowerPoint. So just simply to erase, position the mouse pointer here, you hold down your mouse, do not release, then drag to the right, then drag down to select the placeholders. Then this time it is already selected, then you can press delete on the keyboard. Press once delete, then you can erase all the placeholders. Okay, so this time, if you want paperless, I have already sent a guide for each slide content in our activity 1. Okay, so you can do the same in Microsoft Word. You can tile windows. Okay, so you can open the guide for activity here. This is a picture, a PNG file. You can double click to open your guide. Okay, so this time you can now open PowerPoint here at the taskbar, and this time you can point at the title bar and then drag to the left most of your screen, and you can see it tile windows. Okay, so this time you can click your guide, and then this is your slide number 1. Okay, so to insert word art, you can simply maximize this one, so that you can see, you can click insert and you can see word art, or click the word art. Okay, so click this one and then choose any of these selections in the word art. Okay, so you can click once to select. Okay, then type your the same text with our activity 1, which is the effective study habits. Okay, so you can move the text by simply the same in Microsoft Word, moving the text or graphics on the screen. You just simply point the mouse pointer anywhere on the boundaries of the placeholders. Here, if the mouse pointer looks like a four-headed arrow, and you can hold down your mouse, that means you can move. See, you can move. Okay, so to resize the text or to change the font size, the same in Microsoft Word, just simply highlight the text and then you click home, and here you can see the font size. Okay, so if you want to change it to 72, you can select this one, and then you can also change the font style here. Okay, so instance, you like this AR Darling font style. Okay, so then you decrease. You can also type the size of the text. For example, you like or you want 65, but you press enter to take effect. So this time you can actually customize the color of the text. So to customize, just simply highlight the text or click here at the beginning, and then you highlight, and then you can simply click the format. Here you can see the text fill, so meaning the color inside the text. Okay, so for instance, you want this color here, purple. Okay, so you can select that one, and then this is the outline color. So for example, you want yellow. Okay, so, and if you want to change the thickness of text outline, you can select this one. The same in Microsoft Word, you can click wait, then you can click the 1/4 point thickness of the line. So okay, or 1 1/2. Okay, so for instance, that's your make your own design, as long as the content is the same with content that is required in every slide. So okay, so that's how to customize text and also apply effects. Okay, so select the text, you can click here, so text effects, and then you can actually choose if you want shadow here, you can select. If you want reflection, you can select here any reflection you want. You can select glow, any glow you want. Okay, so level, okay, 3D rotation, okay, and transform. So actually you can make an arc, okay, for instance this one. Okay, you can select this one, then you want to move down, point the mouse pointer at the boundary here, hold down your left mouse button. If the mouse pointer looks like a four-headed arrow, it means it's how to move. Okay, it's our indicator that you can move and graphics on slide or on the screen. Okay so going back to your guide here, the effective study habit. So going back to PowerPoint, going to type here again your name. Okay, so insert again, insert word art here, select word art you want. Okay, for instance one. Okay, then type x by, okay, for instance sentence case by, you type your name. Okay, so you can move down here. Okay, so for instance you are going to background first slide. Okay, you can select sample design here and select backgrounds here. Okay, so there are several options for design. Okay, so for example one, like here, so choose any background you want. Okay, for example this one. Okay, so adjust your text for example to move down. Okay, so if you're going to remove your background, simply select this no background. Okay, so if you want to download images on Google and you want it as your background, so you search the image to Google and then you download and then you copy and paste here in Microsoft PowerPoint. So for instance here I have images already saved in a folder. So for example this one, you browse for the image you want to put as a background, then you can click copy, you right click on the image, copy, and then open the PowerPoint, and then you can right click anywhere here at the empty portion of your slide, right click, and then you can paste. Okay, so this time it covers your text. Okay, you can simply with this background selected, you can see there are resizing handles or resizing box or circles, and select this here to change the order of your text and background. Okay, so you can click here in the arrow and then you click send to back. Okay, so that's how. And then this time you can resize by simply dragging the resizing handles. Okay, so you hold down your left mouse button to resize. Okay, so for example if you want this background to apply on the next slide, to maximize your time creating your activity, you can simply, aside from clicking the new slide to create a new slide that will create a blank slide, you can simply right click on the slide here, right click, and then you can duplicate, left click to duplicate slide. Okay, here you can see you have already two same slides because you have duplicated that slide. Okay, so this time you can now simply edit, you click the second slide and then you can simply edit here. So for instance your slide is one before class physical readiness. Okay, so you can simply edit this one, click and then type okay, and then you can press enter and type okay. So you can simply point the mouse pointer at the boundary here and drag down, hold down your left mouse button and then drag down. Okay, so this time you can delete this one by simply clicking here and then click on the boundary to remove this bar pointer here anywhere at the boundary. And this time you can now delete if the boundary is not showing inside the box. Okay, so delete, remove. Okay, so next, going to type plenty of sleep. So this time, going to insert bullets. Okay, so how to insert customized bullets in Microsoft PowerPoint. Okay, so this is how. Simply to type text in, aside from inserting word art, you can type text in PowerPoint by simply clicking the insert and then shapes and then this text box. Okay, so after clicking the text box, you position your mouse pointer here and then you hold down your left mouse button to create box. Okay, so for your text, okay, so for instance, you increase the size of the text. For instance, you hit before. Okay. This time, you can insert bullets here by clicking here at the bullets to create a bullet list. Select this one. You can actually select this one. And then, you can type text. Okay, so if you want to customize your bullet list, you can click here again. And then, you click bullets and numbering. And then click customize once, and this time you can select your bullets here. Okay, so quickly click this one, arrow, scroll down and look for wingdings. Okay, so scroll down and click or look for wingdings. Okay, for instance, this one, you click this one, you can now select a this bits that you need to apply in your. So, for instance, I'm going to choose this one and then click insert. Okay, and then select this one and then click OK. So, it changes already to post bullet. So, this time you can now type. Okay. Since this is a bullet, please, when you press enter, it automatically creates. At least, okay, then press the spacebar once and then look at your guide up early. Then next, you're going to run, enter. Okay, so right click this one to correct. Okay, so for instance, you press again the text, you highlight and then you increase the size of the text. 6 or 48. Okay, 48. Move by simply dragging. That's how to create a bullet list of PowerPoint or to customize. You can spacebar here, bar to adjust. Okay, so you can click this slide. You right click this slide number 2 and then duplicate slide. Okay, so that you can maximize your time, just simply edit here. Look at your guide, click slide number 3, mental readiness. Okay, going back to PowerPoint, then you type, press enter. Okay, look at your guide, class prepared with assignment. Okay, just simply edit. Okay, so read in advance. Okay, and then you erase the bullet list by pressing the backspace. Okay, so how to duplicate layer to maximize your time creating your activity number. So you do the same to slide. That's all I have to do today. Thank you so much for watching.